Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making a garlic aioli sauce, and we're going to do it with a blender. You may have seen this done with a large bowl and a whisk. You can do that if you want to. I chose to use a blender to make this really easy. And if you're not familiar with aioli sauce, it can be used as a sandwich spread. My purpose here is to make a spread that will go on some French bread that I plan to make with an Italian meal tonight. So my long-term goal is to get some nice bread out of it, but I thought I'd show you my process of making the garlic aioli sauce. So you start with some garlic, and I used 2 cloves that you can see down here on my cutting board, about this size. And I gave each one of them a smash. Actually, I put my knife over it and gave it a smash with my hand, and that releases a lot of juices. And then you want to mince it very finely. So this is the result of mincing 2 cloves of garlic very finely. Once you get to that point, then you want to add some salt. And it's best, I think, to do some coarse salt, coarsely ground salt. So this is Atlantic sea salt, and I have almost 1/4 of a teaspoon here, so I'm just going to put that over the top of the garlic. And you could actually use a little more, so I'll just demonstrate. You can grind it like this and get about 1/4 of a teaspoon, and then use your knife to continue getting the salt combined in with the garlic. And what this does is to bring the juice and flavor out of the garlic. So work that in very well. And then we'll turn to some of the other items that we have to deal with. Actually, I think I will remove this from my cutting board and place it in a bowl so I'll be able to get it in my blender more easily than coming from the cutting board. So I'll just kind of scoop this up with my knife and slide it off there. And those are 2 cloves of salted garlic, ready to go. Now what I want to add into my blender will be 2 egg yolks. You can't really see very well because one of them broke. I think the other one stayed intact, but there are 2 of them in here, and they were large eggs, so they're not tremendously jumbo sized or anything like that, but they're not tiny. So you just go ahead and open your blender and slide those in. And if one of them has broken like this, then you may need a spatula to get all of that in. And then I will add my garlic mixture to it. So here we go with our salted garlic. And then the idea is to whip this up. And as I said, you could do it with a whisk, but we're going to do it with this blender. So I want to start by just pulsing it a bit. And then later I'll be adding some olive oil. I have my extra virgin olive oil sitting here, and I've measured out 1 cup, and if it needs that much, we'll use it, but you can sort of tell as it's blending how much it's going to need. So now I'm just going to pulse the egg and the garlic and let it see what it looks like a little bit, and then I can set it on a low setting and start to pour this through the top, because this can be removed from the top. So pulsing gives you your start, and then you could actually just set it on, I think that the lowest one here is great, and I can just press the on, and it will go at that low thing. I'll turn that off while I talk. But what I plan to do is just take this off. I'm going to take the lid off and then swivel this around so it will come out. There are some notches that match up, and then you can take this out, put it back on, and we'll start by just slowly putting a little bit of this oil in, and I'll just pulse as we go. So we're just going to press pulse like this, and then give it just a little bit of the oil, trying not to spill it all over place. And then I'm going to get to the point where I just turn it on and leave it on. So it's going to be noisy. Let me go away and I'll just continue to pour this slowly, and then I can pour it more rapidly, and I can also increase the speed later on in this procedure. So I'll come back and show you where I've gotten to in a few minutes. Okay, let's turn this off. And I think that has blended pretty well, so I'm going to take the lid off. I did put the entire lid on to keep it from splashing out the top. And then we're going to undo this, take it out, and I've got a little bowl here for it. But I have to reach way down in there, so I have a long spatula type utensil. And you see, it's going to look kind of like mayonnaise in texture. It's really sort of a mayonnaise, but it's garlic flavored and it's very pungent right now. You can smell it in my kitchen very much. And I'll work on that a little bit because there's more in there. But you can see how much it made. And I decided to just use half of the cup of olive oil. You can just use your own judgment on that. When it gets to be the texture that you like, then just go ahead and stop the blending. But what I'm going to do with this is put it in the refrigerator, and then when I get ready to make my French bread, actually, I'm going to spread the bread. I'm going to slice it open and spread the bread with this, and then I will be baking it in the oven. So there are no worries about raw eggs or anything like that. If you plan to spread sandwiches with it or use it as a dip or in some other fashion, then you might want to use pasteurized eggs or maybe some substitute so that you wouldn't be using raw eggs. But raw eggs are fine as long as you feel like they're safe and there are no cracks in them or anything like that. So here is our final dish, and that is our garlic aioli sauce. Hope you like it.